कोई कोई टेक्निकल बात मत करिए आप. डोंट डू एनी टेक्निकल थिंग. यू सिंपली यू टेक लंबी सांस लीजिए और लंबी सांस छोड़िए. And then meditation and dietary modulation. Before I have closed it down, I will give you one example only. I will take only another 2 minutes. कोई एक आदमी बहुत बहुत बुरी तरह से रो रहा, विलाप कर रहा है, बेबी लेडी स्त्री हो या पुरुष हो, कोई भी हो, आप वो रो रहा है, आप उसकी नाक बंद कर दीजिए. वो रो रहा है या रो रही है बिकॉज ऑफ सर्टन रीजन, कुछ न कुछ तो कारण होगा, उसकी नाक बंद कर दीजिए आप. What will be the result? वो उसका रोना बंद हो जाएगा. इमीडिएट उसका रोना बंद हो जाएगा और वो कहेगा या कहेगी, मेरी नाक छोड़ो, मेरा दम घुट रहा. क्या रोने का कारण खत्म हो गया क्या नाक बंद करने से? नहीं खत्म हुआ. हुआ क्या कि उसका मन जो वहां था, जिसकी वजह से वो रो रहा था या रो रही थी, वहां से हट के और आपके ब्रेथ पर आ गया. दैट इज हाउ देयर इज अ क्लोज एफिनिटी इन बिटवीन mind and your breath. So agar aap, if you want to control, if you want to nourish your mind, you have to have the practice of deep breath. That's all. Nothing is specific. And if you will have the control over your mind, I'm sure you will get rid of many, because you cannot change the circumstances. You can, Dr. Patel was telling, in Delhi, you go in Delhi, what is the situation? In Ahmedabad, I don't know, I am quite newcomer to Ahmedabad, but the people told me a few months back that the situation in Ahmedabad city was quite pleasant, like in Gandhinagar nowadays. But now, I was coming, while coming to this conference venue, I planned it for half an hour and it took 1 hour to reach here from Gandhinagar sector 30. Because of the heavy traffic. So scenario is going to change. You cannot change these things. Vehicular traffic is going on increasing day by day. But at least you can control yourself up to certain extent. So these are certain composite. This is a one composite model. By adopting it, you can control this state of stress. And then there is a relationship between stress and food. Dietary management. Before I close, I would like to tell you about the diet. These are 4 tips. Time and frequency. You have to have a set time for your meals. Friends, I'm not saying you stop everything. But if you have a schedule to reach your office at 10 o'clock, why not to have a schedule to take your breakfast at 8 o'clock? Why not to avoid taking ऐसा लगता है जैसे कि जानवरों की तरह से चलते रहते दिन भर. सुबह ब्रेकफास्ट किया, पहले बेड टी लिया, फिर उसके बाद नाश्ता लिया, फिर उसके बाद गए तो समोसा खा लिया, फिर अरोड़ा साहब मिल गए तो फिर उनके साथ गए तो एक कॉफी पी ली, फिर एक बार गए तो बर्गर खा लिया, फिर सैंडविच खा लिया, फिर उसके बाद दोपहर का लंच आधा खाया आधा छोड़ा, फिर उसके बाद 4 बजे फिर चाय पी ली, फिर उसके बाद कॉफी पी ली. There is no stopper, there is no rule, there is no rider and there is no regulation. Why? You know, there should be 5 hours gap in between 2 solid meals, friends. Make it a point. Do bhojan ke beech mein 5 ghante ka gap hona chahiye, and if you want to take anything, you can take only liquid, only and only liquid, no solid. Can you do it? I will request if you do it, well and good. Otherwise, aapki jindagi to apni hai. Then quality and quantity. What you have to eat? What you have to eat and how much you have to eat? I told you in the beginning, carbohydrate, protein, fat, vitamins and minerals. Iske alawa hum log kisi cheez ki zarurat nahi. Hum jitne bhi cheeze chahe, jitne fast foods hai, including tea and coffee. These are not desired at all. और उसके बाद तो बाकी चीजें तो और भी, उसके आगे वाली चीजें जो है वो तो डोमिनोज है और ये है और वो है, वो एवरीथिंग यू नो वेरी वेल. देन कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ इंग्रेडिएंट्स इन 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 केस ऑफ, देखिए द पर्सन हु इज सफरिंग फ्रॉम diabetes, the carbohydrates is prohibited to that particular person. But you require carbohydrate for the instant energy. So what should be done in that case? Carbohydrate to mile, but in what way? That is important. You have to decide that. And then special requirement, if any. If you have diabetes, then you have to eat meat. Wherever you have meat, there will be carbohydrate. Carbohydrate is necessary, but meat is not necessary. So you have to consume those items which contain carbohydrate, but they doesn't cause any kind of upregulation in your diabetes. So these are few things by which if you adopt, if you practice, I think you will get rid of stress. And if you are getting rid of stress, I think you will remain healthy and you will have a longevity. You will have jina bahut mahatvapurna nahi hai. जीना मित्र बहुत महत्वपूर्ण नहीं है, सुख से जीना महत्वपूर्ण है, और सुख की परिभाषा सिर्फ एक ही है, स्वस्थ रह के आपको जीना चाहिए. That's what I would like to request you. Thank you very much. Thanks.
Thank you, Professor Mishra. Next keynote speaker for the day is Dr. Jesh Kumar Jha from Pandit Deendayal Petroleum University, Gandhinagar. Dr. Jha has done his PhD from SPN, National Institute of Technology, Surat. He has published more than 60 research papers in international reference journals, international national conferences of proceedings. Dr. Jha has presented the research work in conferences organized in India, Singapore, Sri Lanka, etc. He has been awarded Institute Fellowship from SVNIT Surat for his PhD during July 2009 to 2012. Dr. Jha. Please, sir.
Eminent questions on the dais. Dear participants, ladies and gentlemen, good morning to all of you. On this occasion, I used to come here last 2 years. I came and definitely we have shared some information regarding the interdisciplinary research areas. Today I would like to share some interdisciplinary areas related to my work. Purpose to discuss with you only to collaborate the different sciences. I am basically from the mathematics department, but working on the computational neuroscience. A little bit you may get different. You may say as person are working in the value, that is a different thing, but I will take hardly 5 to 10 minutes only. We are behind the time. I use these two words only, the calcium signaling and the neuronal disorder. I will start with the biology, then I will enter into the mathematics. Some result I will show you we have done earlier, but right now we are working on the neuronal disorders. Neuronal disorders like Alzheimer, Parkinson, these things we are doing. So, we start with the first neuronal disorder, Alzheimer disease. We used to listen about the Alzheimer, about 5 crores of our population are suffering from the dementia. And one of the diseases is Alzheimer. So, these are the symptoms of the Alzheimer. Here you will see the first arrow is Alzheimer, who have studied the physiology of Alzheimer's brain to a patient that he has cited some references also. But the basic thing is what, when we feel we are not able to respond, it is not always urgently. Sometimes in the stress also we respond slowly, right? But when we have the over age, then these kind of symptoms you will feel after 60 or maybe to 65. So that some symptoms to respond to the fingers, that you see it will respond late. Sometimes they forget to do work. So these are the symptoms. But we are not worried about the particular system, symptom. We are worried about why it happens and where it happens, so that we can correlate with the neuroscience also. These are the, I leave it, these are the symptoms, whatever we have. Okay, when we respond late, then what happens in our nervous system? Here, I will show you the one figure only. This is a, you can consider any cell body, just like you know, astrocyte in our central nervous system. What happens here? This calcium ion enters into the, that cytosol, and in the bubbles form, you will see it is a neurotransmitter, right? Due to the high concentration level of the calcium concentration, these bubbles move towards this synapse, and it will diffuse into the synapse. And here, the some receptors are there that will receive the information. This is the purpose of the study to signaling processes. Earlier, we are working on this. We are calculating the impact of many parameters, just like the protein, that we say the buffers, sodium calcium messenger, endocannabinoid reticulum, mitochondria. Then we have studied mathematically to study the this calcium concentration level that allows the neurotransmitter to move from one cell to another cell at some part level. Later on, we go to the this Alzheimer's disease, and we try to correlate this Alzheimer's disease to the calcium signaling. So that we have reviewed some papers where we get that when we talk about the buffering process. Buffering is what, such proteins are there that react to the calcium ion and that makes the calcium bond buffer, so that it reduces the calcium concentration level. If it not happens,